can work through those who praise him. Praise the Lord.
Welcome to day 10 of our 21-day Daniel fast. Thank you for your commitment to pray and fast for 21 days. Church, I'm believing for breakthrough, deliverance, healing, restoration, and revival. Thank you for standing in the gap, for interceding. You are a watchman on the wall. Today we are going to the book of Matthew, chapter 6, verses 9 to 13, for one of the most important prayers in the Word of God. This is Jesus teaching the disciples how to pray. Verse 9, in this manner, therefore, pray, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, on this day we come before you. And Lord, I join by faith with the people of God. And we start this prayer by giving you praise. Hallowed be your name. Holy is the Lord. So Lord, we honor you today. We exalt you. We magnify you. Lord, we lift you up above all things. We pray, Lord, that you would take preeminence in our situation, in our lives, in our homes, and in our families. Jesus is Lord. Lord, we give you praise. Lord, your word says that your will is to be done. Jesus, that's how you taught us to pray your will be done in earth as it is in heaven. So Lord, we pray your will to be done. We pray your will to be done among the people of God. We pray your will to be done across this nation. We pray your will to be done in our own hearts and in our own lives. Lord, not my will, not my agenda, not my purpose. Lord, not my will, but yours be done. So Lord, I pray this over the people of God, that we would put aside our own agendas, our own plans. We would not demand our way or order our own desires, but I pray that your will be done, your purposes be done, that you would have your way. Church, say that with me. Lord, have your way. Lord, have your way. Lord, have your way in my life, my home, my family, my church. Lord, have your way. And God, we pray that you would deliver us from evil. Lord, this is how you taught us to pray. And we pray that the enemy would be defeated. We pray, Lord, that you'd help us turn away from temptation. Keep us from falling. Give us the strength to persevere in a difficult season. Lord, we just recognize, we declare that you are Lord of all. We declare the enemy is a liar. And I pray today that you would deliver us in Jesus' name. Come on, church. I pray that God would deliver us from evil. Deliver us from temptation. Deliver us from being distracted. Deliver us from being discouraged. Deliver us from being distracted. Lord, I pray the people of God would rise up in Jesus' name, and we would put the enemy under our feet. Glory to God. And so, Lord, I also pray, Lord, as we conclude this prayer, that you would deliver us from evil. And then we say, to God be the glory. Lord, thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and all. Lord, we give you praise. You're worthy to be praised. I pray for the people of God today as we continue to fast and pray. I pray for breakthrough. I pray for testimony. I pray, Lord, that you would do the impossible. Go ahead, Lord. We just ask for you to breathe upon us. I pray for miracles for the people of God, breakthrough for the people of God, restoration for the people of God, joy for the people of God, healing for the people of God. To God be the glory. Great things you have done, great things you are doing, and great things you're about to do. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you.